Ling Jihua had gotten so close to the top of the mountain. After serving as the gatekeeper to China's top party leaders, he had been poised to take a position amongst them. But his path would forever change in a single night, with his son Ling Gu dying in a fiery car crash while driving a black Ferrari Spider. What would ordinarily be a tragic event for a parent turned into a public embarrassment for himself and the party he worked for. Uncomfortable, unavoidable questions came up about Ling's family and the wealth that his position presumably afforded him. The crash and the cover-up that followed led to Ling's downfall. In this video, I want to look at the fourth of the big four corrupt tigers that went down during Xi Jinping's big anti-corruption drive, and I feel one of the most dramatic. But first, I want to talk a little bit about the Asianometry newsletter. I know that there's a lot of videos on this channel, and despite going back many years, much of the content is still relevant quite even to today. However, several people have told me that the big backlog can be a little intimidating. The newsletter helps get you started with some of the best hits. You can find the link to the newsletter in the video description below, or you can just go to asianometry.com. You can expect a new newsletter every 4 days at 1 a.m. Taiwan time. Much thanks. Ling Jihua was born October 22, 1956, in the agricultural county of Pinglu in the Shanxi province in northern China. His father was a doctor who joined the Communist Party during the 1930s. Due to his father's passion for the party, Ling Jihua and his siblings were named after key tenets of the party's philosophy. Jihua means planning, though it might not sound like that due to my atrocious tones. As a child, he was said to be a smart and studious kid, respectful to his elders and a good student in class. His teachers praised him for his attitude. After serving at an agricultural machinery station in the country as part of the Down to Countryside movement, he joined the Communist Party in June 1976 and became Deputy Secretary of the Pinglu County Party Committee. In 1979, the Communist Youth League sought to find and elevate great talents from around the country. Ling was selected and brought to work in the CYL propaganda department. At this time, the Communist Youth League was one of the Chinese Communist Party's larger power centers. The CYL traces its existence back to 1922 as the Chinese Socialist Youth League. As of 2015, it had 87.5 million members. Youth leagues like the CYL play a critical role in the Leninist-style Communist Party. Lenin believed strongly, and rightfully so, that the youth needed correct political education. The Youth League would be a way to recruit people into the party, indoctrinate them in the party's views, and also groom its future leaders. In 1980, Deng Xiaoping declared that when it came to deciding promotions, the party should not focus so much on class origin like it once did during the Mao era. Rather, it should look to recruit younger, more educated, and technically specialized type folks. This, in addition to implementation of retirement age limits, meant that a whole bunch of new positions were made available to young party members, and the Communist Youth League members filled a great deal of those positions. You see, the retirement age limit set a bunch of norms throughout the party ranks. Because members had to ultimately retire at a certain age, if they did not reach a certain rank by a certain age, then their career stalled. It's very much how, like, your Asian parents are always saying to you, you need to buy a house by age 27, get married by age 30, kids by 32, or else you are falling behind and doomed to die alone. Hit the milestones or you are out. The Communist Youth League had age limits as well, and they were quite low. The reasons for this are pretty obvious. It's a youth league. But setting them so low had significant consequences. It meant that the CYL's top leaders had to transfer out of the CYL much younger. For example, the CYL Central Committee First Secretary had to leave his position by age 45. So these baby birds had to leave the nest unusually early. A bunch of these transfers failed to find a new position and their career stalled. But some succeeded. Their former high-level position in a national organization like the CYL made them qualified for a similarly high position within the party state organization, like at a provincial level. And crucially, they transfer into that position much younger than their peers. It gives them a critical head start on the career track, and led to many of them getting promoted into top national level positions. Hu Jintao was one of these types. In 1984, Hu Jintao became CYL Central Committee First Secretary, its number one leader. A year later, he transferred at the age of 43 to Provincial Committee Secretary of Guizhou, much younger than his peers, and on the right track for higher leadership later on. So, after serving in the CYL for 10 years, Ling Jihua likely aged out and needed a new job. He thus transferred to the General Office of the Central Committee of the Communist Party, where he worked in the research group. This office is quite important, as it deals with the administrative affairs of the party's Central Committee. It deals with top leader security, medical issues, logistics, so on. So it's like the White House chief of staff. Critically, it also does research for and provides the briefings that those top leaders will see. As they say in certain places, you get great face time with top management. Hu Jintao would later rise to become General Secretary of the Communist Party. You might think that Hu was Ling's patron throughout his career. After all, they both come from the CYL. Definitely possible that that might have something to do with it, but I'm not entirely quite sure. Ling did join the general office 7 years before Hu became paramount leader, after all. What seems more likely to me is that Ling, same as Hu, joined a high-ranking organization on the back of his work in the CYL. Once there, he gained Hu's trust by delivering good information, following through on work tasks, and managing Hu's administrative issues well. Chief of staff stuff. Everyone values a worker who gets stuff done. Anyway, by 2012, Ling had been director of the general office, chief of staff of the office of Hu Jintao, and a secretary of the central secretariat for the 17th Central Committee, an office that helps carry out the routine operations of the Politburo. Future General Secretary Xi Jinping led that particular secretariat, which goes to show just how big of a deal it was to be on it. So all in all, yeah, Ling Jihua was moving up in the world. He perhaps had the chance to become a member of the Politburo, one of the 25 most powerful people in China. And then it was gone. Ling Jihua's only son, Ling Gu, was born 1988 to Ling Jihua and his wife, Gu Liping. There is not too much information about the son before the car crash, but it seems that he graduated from Peking University in the School of International Relations in 2011 before studying education as a graduate student. He lived off campus in a private residence, did not pay much attention in class, and kept a low profile. On March 18, 2012, Ling Gu died in a car crash in Beijing while driving a black Ferrari 458 Spider. The car had lost control and hit a wall at high speed, basically disintegrating upon impact. He had been riding with two women, both of whom later died in the hospital. Photos began circulating on Weibo, and a few reports appeared in the media. Then, within a day of the crash, the authorities began cracking down. Search terms on Sina Weibo, Baidu, and Soso reported that searches for Ferrari and, quote, Master Ling, end quote. And then after that, quote, Beijing Ferrari car accident, end quote. The Global Times removed his news story covering the incident, but the specific words for Ling Jihua and Ling Gu remained uncensored, probably because doing so would confirm that something was wrong. 3 months later, someone posted on Ling Gu's social media account, "Thank you, I'm well, don't worry," under his name. As the New York Times noted, this fake message was posted as part of a coordinated cover-up of the incident. There are a few wild rumors flying about how Ling might have struck deals with Zhou Yongkang and Jiang Zemin, not the former paramount leader, but the head of the oil company. Members of the powerful state oil apparatus to aid in the cover-up, but the later anti-corruption investigation never said anything officially about it. Ling Jihua, for his part, continued on like as if everything was normal. Nicholas Kristof wrote on the Times that he heard that Ling went to the morgue, looked at the body, and then coldly denied that it was his son. The following weeks, he went back to the office and worked normal days. The cover-up failed. Word got out, and obviously people questioned how a seemingly ordinary party official, one that most have never heard of, could have accumulated such wealth that his son could have bought a fancy $500,000 car. A few months later, in September 2012, Ling Jihua was transferred out of the general office to work for the United Front Work Department, effectively a demotion. He also did not get promoted to the 25-person Politburo as outside analysts expected. 2 years later, in 2014, two of his brothers were arrested for corruption, a harbinger of things to come. His third brother, Ling Wancheng, fled to the United States. I read a New York Times article back in 2015 about China's request for his repatriation. Looks like nothing has happened about that since then. Ling himself was placed under disciplinary investigation by the Central Commission for Discipline Inspection in December 2014. Over the next few months, he would be removed from all of the senior positions and then shortly thereafter ejected from the party entirely. After the party's declaration and Ling Jihua had been put under investigation, internet censorship lifted on keywords surrounding the Beijing Ferrari crash. On July 4, 2016, Ling Jihua was sentenced to life imprisonment and deprived of his political rights and private property. His crimes were, quote, violating political discipline, violating political rules, violating organizational discipline, and violating confidentiality discipline, end quote. He also was accused of taking $11 million USD in bribes through his wife, as well as sexual misconduct with multiple women. Ling did not contest the sentence. He thanked the court and its lawyers for their work, saying that embodied in a combination of rule of law and humanitarian treatment. "I accept all the charges and submit to the judgment. The trial was solemn, meticulous, rational, and civilized." Ling Jihua is considered one of the big four corrupt tigers alongside Bo Xilai, Xu Kaihao, and Zhou Yongkang. It is what it is, and that's what the party says. But if you ask me, something about that classification kind of does not feel right with me. The other three tigers were legit tigers. Zhou and Xu had been one of the most powerful men in China. Bo Xilai was on his way there, and he had all that prestigious background. Ling Jihua had a pretty high position, but he stayed behind the scenes. He kind of was a nobody, and I don't think anyone ever really thought about him before the car crash. I wonder if the crash never happened, then maybe Ling Jihua would still be a party member, might even be part of the Politburo, and things, I guess, might have been much different. But who knows? But the car crash embarrassed the party, and it unveiled unpleasant things about its senior members. And no matter how powerful you are, or can be, nobody is higher than the party, and nobody can jeopardize its image. Ling Jihua paid for that. Alright everyone, that's it for today. Check out the newsletter and sign up if you haven't already. And check out the Patreon, as always. Until next time, I'll see you guys later.